Hello everyone, this is part 8 on introduction to Scratch programming, and in this video we will be looking upon the sensing blocks in Scratch. So as you will see that most of the blocks in sensing are boolean types block. So I told you about booleans in the previous video in the controls section here when I was explaining about if condition and if else conditionals. So as you can see that most of the sensing blocks here are boolean blocks here. Let me give you a brief summary about booleans. Booleans are the types of blocks which have only two answers with them, whether it can be true or false. So as you can see, when you will be guessing about the answers which the question here is asking, then you can get only two answers, true or false. So let's start with the first block here, which is touching mouse pointer. So as you can see, by seeing the name you can guess what this block is going to say. That it's saying that whenever the cat here, as I'm in the cat sprite here, whenever the cat will be touching the mouse, which is this mouse here, then it would do the coding here, which is present here. So let's do like that, play sound until done. So what it will do is, when green flag will be clicked, then forever it will go in this loop, and it will check that whenever the cat is touching my mouse, then it will play the meow sound. So let's check. I click the green flag, and let's see, when I hover my mouse over the cat, then see what happens. Cat says meow. So that's how it works. You can also do something like say hello for 2 seconds. So it says hello for 2 seconds like that. If I remove that my mouse there, and even if I go again, then it will say hello again. So as you can see, there is a drop down menu here, and here there is an option of edge, and when you will take other sprites, then you will also have the option of the names. So let's check that. I'll put the cat here like that, and when I click the green flag, then it says hello. And as it is touching the edge here, edges are the lines, as you might know, about the stage. So when I remove that, so the cat won't say hello anymore. So let's look upon the next block here, which is touching color this. So for that, let's paint a sprite. Before that, let's check about the color here, which is 1969. Let's put that to red there like that, and let's paint a sprite here, and let me make that red. So let me clear the outline there. And as you'll see that I made a good square there. And let's go in our cat sprite again, and let's put only a little bit portion of the cat above the block here, which is a square. So when I click the green flag, it says hello, and when I remove that, it won't say. So that's how it works. So these sensing blocks will be helping you to make your games like platformer games and much more like that. So let's delete this block. But before that, let's look at this too. This block touching this color is touching this color. So this block is not used much, but let's see what happens. So as you can see, when I click on this And when I click on this icon here, as you can see, only the stage here highlights. So I can select the color I want, like this color. And let's place here black, as the mustache of cat here is black. So let's look on that. So now when I click the green flag, then the cat says hello, and as it won't be touching anymore, then the cat won't. So that this is something like it's not about only this sprite. If any other sprite is also touching this block here, which is red, then it would do the same thing. Like, let me show you that. I'll paint another box here with black color. Let's make that black there. And so now when I click the green flag, okay, why isn't it working? Okay, so it's not working right now, but it would work like when this sprite will be touching the red color here, then it would work. But for some reason now it's not working. I don't know why. So by the way, let's move to the next block here, which is distance to mouse pointer. So when I click that, as you will see, there's a big random value. So this is something like the cat's distance from the center. As you will see, that cat center here is this. This is the center of the cat. So from that center, the distance to the mouse would be the number here, the number of pixels there. So if I put that block here and I click that, so it would be like 109. And now let's put that into the let's say greater than, and let's put that in the first. So now what happens is it says hello, and now when I okay, true. Okay, so as the distance to the mouse pointer of the cat is greater than 50, then it would say hello for 2 seconds. As it is greater, so it would be just like here. And as you can see that when I place the mouse over the cat there, as it is less than 50 only there, then only this would work. So like, let's put that to 200, and now let's see what happens. So as you can see, nothing will happen, but as I place my mouse far from the cat, then as you will see that it says hello. So I hope you have understood about distance of mouse pointer, but if you haven't understood, that won't be a big issue, as it is not necessary now. And now the most interesting block, let's come to that, which is ask what's your name and wait. So like, let's remove this and put this here. So as you can see that it is very similar to this say hello block here, but it is asking. So why is it like that? Let's check by putting a condition here, which is if touching mouse pointer. So like, when I click the green flag, and it would say what's your name. So as you can see that it's saying what's your name, as simple as that. But as you will see that there is a option here in which you can write like something like like that. So whenever my mouse will be touching the cat, then it would ask what's your name. So like, let me put something randomly like that. You can work by taking an input from the user. So like, what you can do is, now as you have took input from the user, now you can make something like validation of the answer. So that's why you have this answer block here. So let's check that by removing this. Let me check that if answer is equal to, let me put that what's your name before that. So like, if answer is equal to like GK, and now I can make the cat say hi GK. So when I click the green flag, it firstly asks me what's her name. I say like GK, so it says hi GK. And say GK, and it goes on. So now you can take input from the user, as when you will be learning about programming language further after completing Scratch and that all, then you will be finding easy to learn these programming languages as you have took the user input from now. So you can do just like ask like what's your age. So let me put that when green flag clicked, ask what's your age. And now let's look upon the uses of this user input. So like, I'll take an if else here. And now let's say like, from the operators we can say like this greater than operator here, and let's put the answer here, and the second number input we can do just like 18, and let me make the cat say twice something like, if the age of the user is greater than 18, then we can say that you can drive. And in the else section we can write like you can't drive, like that. And now when I click the green flag, it says what's your age. So like, I'll put 56, then it says you can drive. And when I click the green flag again, I'll say just like 17, it says you can't drive. So like this, we can take some input from the user, and then later we can execute that. So this is how it will work. So now let's come to the next block here, which is this key pressed. So when I use that, something like, when I want to make a game in which my cat can move, so I can say like, if this is as similar from the events block when space key is pressed. So but it will only work under a certain event. So as now, if you don't want something like to happen every time when your player has lives and that all, so you can use this. So I can duplicate that. Duplicate that, and let me tell you that we can use them like that. When I place one after the other and replacing the space key, let me use all the arrow keys there, right and right and left there. And so now from motion we can use, so like change x by 10 or not, change x by 10 would be not be used from the up arrow, but it would be used from the right and left arrow. And in left arrow we can say like change x by minus 10, and here we can use change y by 10 and change y by minus 10. So when I click the green flag, and now when I use my arrow keys, as you can see the cat moves. So now this will be very helpful for you to make your games under a certain event, not only when any event happens, but under a certain event. So like you can move the cat anywhere on the stage. So where is my cat gone? Yeah. So like that you can use this block here, which is also a boolean block here. And now let's remove that and let's put only a if condition there, and let's remove all those from there. And let's put the if condition there. And now let's move to the next block, which is the mouse down block. So you might be thinking that what is mouse down? So when I click somewhere, like when I tap the mouse, that means the mouse is down. That is as simple as that. And let me see that. Say hello. So like that, when I'll say when green flag is clicked and I click the mouse there, it says hello. As you can see, it says hello. That's very interesting when you want to make some buttons in the code you want for the games. So like if you want any button to only be executed when it would be touching the mouse and the mouse will be down. So like now what will happen is when it would be touching the mouse and the mouse will be down, only then it would say hello. And you will see that when I click the mouse now, then nothing happens. But when I hover my mouse over the cat, and now it says hello. So that is how the mouse down block works. So now let's move to the next two blocks, which are mouse X and mouse Y. So these blocks are using the mouse position from the stage. So they are just similar to these blocks which are X position and Y position. But the only difference here is that these blocks from the motion blocks, they were taking the position of the sprite, but these two blocks here from the sensing, these two blocks will be taking the position of the mouse. So like let's take from operators that when mouse x is equals to mouse y, then it would say hello. So there would be certain points on the graph of the stage where the mouse x will be equal to mouse y. So now let's say that Let me see. Okay, it's not something like that. It is, as I'm not getting the specific point where it should be. So like, let's set the cat's position to 0, 0. So now, so it says hello. So yeah, like that. So when I hover my mouse right there, then it says hello. So there would be certain points like that. As you can see, I would need to choose those points which are little bit difficult to choose when the x and y coordinates should be same. So now let's move to the next two blocks, to the next block, which is set draggable mode. So I hope you have understood the total 10 blocks here. And now let's move to the next block here, which is set drag mode. So this is something like when I click that, and now in the full screen section, when I click on the cat, and I can move that. That is as simple as that. So I can also set that to not draggable. So now what will happen is, when I click the, oh yeah, I have to select that. So I clicked on that, and now let's see, I can't move the cat. So this is a simple block for which you won't need a big code from that, like forever if touching mouse pointer and mouse down, then go to mouse pointer. You won't need that. You can only just click that, and you can do something like that. So the user who would be playing your games or using your animations, then he can drag the cat like that. So it's not much important, as it won't be used any time like that. And now let's move to the next three blocks, which are loudness, timer and reset timer. So let's look upon the loudness. As you can see, whenever I am speaking, the loudness is increasing, and when I stop speaking, the loudness decreases. So as you can see, the loudness was at 2. As you can see, it was again for 2. And it is similar to the loudness section here, but you would have to use that in your games and your animations only if you want that to be done in a boolean system there. So it would be helpful for you to make a boolean variable there, so you can use that. So when I, let me explain you again that loudness is the sound around your microphone. So that is all about the loudness block. Let's look upon the timer here. So as you can see, the timer is continuously changing like that. So when I click the green flag, it sets to 0 and it moves fast. As you can see that whenever you set a timer, then it moves very fast. So like, and this is the time block here. And what if you want the timer to be resetted in your game? So you have this block here, which is reset timer. So as you can see, it resets the timer back to 0 like that. As you can see, now the time is 4 seconds point something. So when I click that, so it was back to 0. So this can be helpful for you to make racing games and such like that. So now you have this block here, which is backdrop number of stage. So as you can see, it says 1 because the backdrop here in the stage, it says 1 here. And when I duplicate that, it would say 2 now. Let me show you that. When I click that, it says now 2 because the backdrop which is selected, it says the its backdrop number here, which is 2. So this can be helpful for you to change the variables which you would be making. I'll tell you about them in the further videos. You would be making some local variables, and you can also change the variables which are local for other sprites and not for this. So as you can see, that backdrop number, backdrop name, volume, and my variable. So let me choose a sprite and let me show you that. So when I select apple there, and now when I hit the drop down menu there, it will also show me the sprites which are there. So before, as there were no sprites, then it showed only me 2 stage, and now it shows me about the apple 2. And now you can see that there are multiple blocks here, so like X position, Y position, direction, costume number, costume name, size, and volume. So when you would be learning about variables, then you can make the variable for the sprite only, like my own variable. So as you will be seeing that this variable is only for this sprite, and when I go in the cat sprite here, that variable hide. So what if you want the variable to show here? So as you can see, you can use this, but it won't be working as a variable, but only as a number input there. So you can also do something like making local variables and using the variables which were made for other sprites. So this would be helping you. And now let's go to the next 3 blocks, which are very funny, and you can do something like, when I click day since 2000, which means that starting from the year 2000, the days till now are 7523 days, and something like that. It counts minutes and that all. As you can see, it's changing from here, as it is decimal value there, so it's changing second by second. And now let's, when I click on the current year here, so I hope you have understood about day since 2000. This is not much used, but let me tell you that. So when I click on the current year block here, it says 2020. So you can also replace them with month, date, day of the week, hour, minute, second. So they would be used like that. And I want you all to check them and write in the comment section down. And now let's move to the last block, which is the username here. So what is this username? So now let me tell you that I'm using the offline editor of Scratch, but whenever you will be posting your games on the Scratch profile, on your Scratch profile, then those games would be available to the whole world. So as you would be making a Scratch profile, then so you would be having some name on that. So you can use this username to make your sprites say the username. Like if I just have this cat here and let's say the username. So when I click that, it won't say anything as I'm using the offline editor now. So when I click on username, it says nothing. So it won't work if you are using the offline editor. But if you are having a Scratch account and you would be making some games to publish on the Scratch profile, then this would work for you. So if I go and do this in the online editor, then it would be showing my username. So I hope you have understood a little bit about the sensing blocks. Let me tell you that these sensing blocks are going to help you very much in your games and enhancing your games by using this mouse down, mouse X and mouse Y, and this space key pressed, and this touching mouse pointer. So these are some most used blocks in sensing. And the another interesting blocks here are ask what's your name and weight, and these blocks here, which is current year, day since 2000. So I found them pretty funny, and so I hope you have understood this complete video. If you understood that and you enjoyed that, then give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, then subscribe it now. And if you have any doubts, then write in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.